For exclusive content, go to DrER.tv.
Hello there, YouTube. So in this video, we're going to talk about the otoscopic exam. Otoscopic meaning coming from the otoscope. This is my digital otoscope. It's got an old iPhone that's cracked, and I put a bag over it to protect me from the broken glass. But it's got this little device that attaches called the otoscope, or cellscope, actually. Cellscope. It has an app, and it allows me to capture live image, and I can show the patient their ear infection, whatever they got. So we're going to go through a couple of ear exams, and then I'll get to discuss it. First, we're going to start with an example of a normal ear exam. In this first video, you're going to see the otoscope going in. This is the outer ear canal, and the tympanic membrane looks nice and pearly and white. And there's a little bit of cerumen plug, not plug, it's just cerumen, but it's supposed to be there. That's what it's there for, to protect the external ear from dust, bacteria, from organisms, from little insects trying to get in and so on. So that is a normal otoscopic exam, a normal tympanic membrane. So this is the same patient, the opposite ear, and you can see the redness of that tympanic membrane. It's very red. The red is dull, it's not shiny anymore, the membrane, although the distal, the southernmost portion there, it's a little shiny there. So this is a otitis media with an effusion. Effusion means there's fluid in that tympanic membrane behind it, pushing it out. And there's again some wax there, but the canal is still intact, and still you can see all the way in. So that's acute otitis media with an effusion. The next one we're gonna see is a patient who had ear pain and then had bleeding coming out of the ear. So we expect to see tympanic membrane perforation. We're gonna start seeing the exam. You can see blood kind of on the canal as we're coming in. And as we go in further, you can see basically the tympanic membrane, you can't see all the way through, and there's a big clot of blood in the bottom. So this is a tympanic membrane perforation. It's a tear, usually caused by infection, but it can also be caused by trauma, by people digging in, by a loud cough. It builds enough pressure to tear through it. Scuba divers can have tympanic membrane ruptures from stuff like that. Loud noises can cause stuff like that. But this particular one occurs secondary to an ear infection, caused a tympanic membrane perforation with hematorrhagia, or bleeding all out of the ear. And if you see blood behind the eardrum, but it's not perforated, it's called hemotympanum, which is blood behind the eardrum. And this other next patient is really kind of interesting. Look at this image. We're going out from the canal, and then we see this tympanic membrane. Well, we don't really even see the tympanic membrane. We see like just fluid and a whole bunch of little bubbles. Those are bubbles. And there should not be any ear behind this. So what's happened to this patient? He had a tympanic membrane perforation. Because of an infection, had ear pain, and then because of blowing his nose or coughing or sneezing, air is going through the eustachian tube into the ear and then blowing out of the tympanic membrane, creating those tiny little bubbles everywhere. So these, again, even though we can't see the tympanic membrane, we know there has to be a tympanic membrane perforation, and that's what's caused all these bubbles on the middle ear. And that's it for now. That's sort of the three different patients, three different ear exams, including a normal exam, for you guys to see what we see when we look at the ears with the otoscope and using this cellscope device. Hope you enjoy that quick teaching.